Blackstone Audio presents Brainwashed, How Universities Indoctrinate America's Youth by Ben Shapiro. This book is read by Chris Abell. To my parents, who taught me the difference between right and wrong and gave me the strength to confront falsehood. Foreword by David Limbaugh. I can't tell you how many times I've heard people, including myself, muse how interesting it would be if they could relive their lives as teenagers or college students with the knowledge, savvy, and experience they have acquired through their additional years. Of course, it's idle fantasy, but as I've come to know Ben Shapiro over the past few years, I've been reminded of that very thought. I've met my share of precocious young adults who were talented in their own way, but never one with the intellectual maturity and insight of Ben. To borrow the cliché, he has wisdom well beyond his years, which is what makes his book, Examining the University Culture, unique. It seems that most of these types of books are written either by professors or those outside the system. By contrast, this book is an insider's look at academic indoctrination from one currently being victimized by it. But Ben's perspective is not limited to that of a university student with blinders to everything but his studies. He is also an astute political analyst and cultural critic, already writing a nationally syndicated column. So, with Brainwashed, we get a sophisticated and firsthand critique of the university as an institution of ideological propaganda for the left-wing, secular worldview. And the book delivers, confirming our worst fears about modern academia. It covers, topic by topic, all the major issues on college campuses and all the major aspects of college life, convincingly documenting the overt liberal bias among professors and shattering the conventional wisdom that their bias is irrelevant to their teaching. The bias has deep historical roots in this country and is growing in intensity. It covers the gamut, from accusing Republicans of stealing the presidential election in 2000, passing tax cuts for the rich, robbing seniors of their Social Security benefits, and poisoning our air and water, to praising the failed system of Marxism and denouncing capitalism. The outrage doesn't end there. Shapiro also documents the shocking professorial promotion of sexual deviancy and even their inexcusable justifications of terrorism. Shapiro goes beyond merely exposing the bias. Using hard data and reasoned argument, he also debunks the myths and distortions propagated by a professoriate incapable of objective analysis because of its ideological enslavement. An example is its blind advocacy of minimum wage laws to help the poor, even though most economists oppose them because they lead to job cutbacks. As Shapiro demonstrates, most professors, and not just those in the political and social science departments, don't even aspire to present a balanced perspective. In many cases, part of their mission is to influence the students' outlook, and they are succeeding. He cites surveys and exit polling data showing that while slightly more college freshmen identify themselves as liberal than conservative, that gap widens substantially as they become upperclassmen. The brainwashing of students transcends the classrooms to the student media using tuition funds and student groups, which themselves often become instruments of left-wing professorial indoctrination. While the left glorifies diversity of race and ethnicity, it actively opposes diversity of thought, considering only leftist ideas acceptable for dissemination. The very ideal of education to create an atmosphere of open inquiry is tacitly mocked in favor of the monolithic liberal agenda. But academic integrity is not the only victim of doctrinaire left-wing academic bias. Truth itself is a casualty as the result of a disturbing trend in academia to fully embrace postmodern moral relativism. How can ideas flowing from traditional values receive a proper airing when the prevailing dogma emphatically rejects moral absolutes? How can students be expected to further their grasp on reality when the university atmosphere teaches that truth is a social construct largely defined by power? Yet, as Shapiro shows, the assault on absolute morality is the basis for every brainwashing scheme of the left. We should all shudder when we realize that the university establishment is training our youth to believe there is no such thing as a neutral or objective claim, and that there is no such thing as evil, except perhaps for political conservatives and big corporations. When a prominent Princeton University professor is not ridiculed and shunned, but celebrated for arguing that it is moral to murder disabled newborn human beings, we ought to understand that something is seriously wrong.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.